Hi, hello viewers. Welcome to linuxhelp.com. In this previous session, we have seen how to install OpManager on CentOS 7 and also how to configure the SNMP v3 credential on OpManager. And in this session, we are going to see how to do rebranding on OpManager and server port setting. First of all, rebranding option helps you replace the OpManager logo that is displayed in the OpManager web client as well as in the downloaded reports with your company logos. You can also change the product name, company name, and copyrights detail, and also server port configuration. In case OpManager has been running on certain port number on your server, for example, 80 is the current running port number for a OpManager client. If you would wish to change the port number for the OpManager, it's very possible to follow the further instruction. Now I'm going to open a terminal. First, we are going to see how to rebranding on OpManager. In my case, OpManager has been already installed on my server. So just I have to check it out the status of OpManager service. The service is already running. So now I'm going to open a OpManager web console. Here I have to give my IP address. And then here I have to give my port number, which is running on OpManager. Now we are getting a login page of OpManager. The site is loading now. Yeah, now we get a OpManager console. Since I have configured localhost only on OpManager, so now I'm going to open setting. And then here we can see the rebranding below in the basic setting. Now we are in a rebranding configuration console. By default, product name is the OpManager. And then here you can choose your product name. I have to give my product name as Linux Help. And then here we can choose the header image. Here I have to choose my image. And then here we can see the two options, background image or background color. So I have to choose background image. And then here I have to choose my image. Now the rebranding configuration is done. Now we can check it out the changes. So now I'm going to log out. Now we can see the changes. The background image is also changed. In before the configuration, here the text as the OpManager. Now we can see the changes. So now I'm going to log in. Now the rebranding session is completed. Then we are going to see how to change the server port number on OpManager for after the installation. So we have to open a terminal. Now I'm going to installation directory of OpManager, opt manager, and then here we have to go to the bin directory, and then here we can list out the files, and here we can see the shell script file for change web server port. Just we have to run the file, and then here we have to choose the new port number. Currently I'm using 8060 is a port number for OpManager. Now I'm going to change into the port number as 8000, then hit enter. Now we are getting a message as the port protocol updated successfully. Now we have to restart the OpManager using the following command. Then hit enter. The service will be restarted now. The service is restarted now. It will take some time for new changes. Now we have to open a browser. The browser is open now. And then here I have to choose my IP address. So here I have to give my IP address. And then here I have to type my new port number for OpManager. The site is open now. Now we are in the login page of OpManager. Now we are getting successfully login after the changing port number for OpManager. In this session, I hope you understand how to change the port number and rebranding on OpManager. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel Linux Help. If you want to further more videos, please visit www.linuxhelp.com. If you have any queries, please mail to support@linuxhelp.com.